on your radio experience. You can count on we're talking Afropop right now on the Sunnyside Show. And we've got an Afropop artist here in the studio with us. You just checked out that song, which is my fave, by the way. I mean, if you know me, you know I love that song.
Yes.
I'm crazy about
that
song.
Do you know the funny thing? You know the funny thing? I said I wasn't going to embarrass you today with that song, so I'm not going to embarrass you with that particular one. He actually does love the song. He's been playing it since forever. I'm excited for you right now, Itodo. Who's welcome? Are you joking? You calm down.
But we've got VI.
Yes.
Well, I love to say VEA.
Yes. Do you know what? Let us just start by dragging her first.
No,
of all.
You can't
drag
her.
Because why did you name yourself VI and spell it VEA?
Because okay, with me, I wanted to be a bit different. I knew people wouldn't be able to pronounce it the first time.
Okay.
So I feel like if you've listened and you've heard and you enjoy my music and you're like, how do you pronounce your stage name? And I say VI, you're probably not going to forget.
Oh,
exactly.
Okay.
So I wanted it to, I want you to learn it by your own choice. Some people call me V, some people call me VA, VIA. But once I've said my name is VI, I don't think it ever leaves your head. It sounds complex.
Yeah, but you know, some people have coconut head. So
because I've heard you say the name as VI.
Yeah.
But I always keep saying VEA because that's how I know it.
And just it sounds, call me V.
But no, we have to add the last name.
I have a tactic actually. So everybody knows Adi Kunle's song with Davido. Me, I just want to VI.
Okay.
Who knew that he was releasing that song for you?
Can you imagine?
Ridonkulous.
Let's talk Young and Reckless right now.
That's right.
That EP is crazy in a good way.
Thank you.
And I don't know. Let's just have you talk about it for a bit so I get to understand what your thought process was like.
So Young and Reckless, I came up with the name just before I entered the house.
Are you reckless though?
I mean, just before the house I was.
But right now,
you know.
Perhaps
you know,
not.
The all the fame and the glitz and the glamour, it kind of humbles you. You're not really the way you were before. But I wanted to still hold on to that just for a second. Before I, you know, advance to other parts of my life and my music, I didn't want to let go of that feeling I had just before the house. I was very young and reckless.
Yeah.
And you know, coming out and maturing, I just wanted to hold on to that last stage before I advance.
Okay.
And it's been a long time coming. It took a while to arrange, to do so many ups and downs, but I'm really, really happy that I'm here. You know, a lot of people told me R&B won't sell in Nigeria. But here we are, over 2 million streams later.
Yeah,
and my baby is actually a month today.
Yay!
Well, it's 4 Fridays, hasn't it? Yeah, it's been 4 Fridays.
So quick one, what's your favorite song?
I was just about to ask that. You've got Do It, you've got Forbidden Fruit, you've got Enter My Head. Which is it?
My favorite song, I can't lie, it's No Time, because No Time is the one that stands out. It's not what you would normally hear in Nigeria. It's a garage beat. It's very UK, it's very raw. And that is I wrote it at a time of my recklessness. If you listen to the lyrics,
interesting.
I'm curious to know what this entails, because it's been in the conversation too much.
That's the name of the EP, Young and Reckless.
I understand why you would want to know. I think he wants to know, and I'm gonna inform you.
Okay.
How do you say this radio friendly? So, you know, as a single, young, pretty, jovial, personality-filled woman, you know.
102.3. Afropop Hour, 2:52. Whoop whoop. Who's excited for VI?
I am excited to have her here, actually, because I'm a big fan of her work and her sound and her friendship.
Oh. Do you see me rolling my eyes?
Well, I should replace both of you right now.
That's not even the point. Let me tell you something. I bet
switch
you
places,
that if she could, she would have video called her friend who liked another friend that she was hanging out with. I'm still not done with that.
What
that's
is going
fine.
On with
that's
you?
That's right. See, it's personal beef right now. That's.
Do you want to give her a backstory real quick?
So here's what it is. Okay. I love Rita Dominic, right?
Uh-huh.
And he knows I love Rita Dominic.
Yeah.
And then Guess what happened? He hung out with Rita for a whole weekend. Guess who now came to work on Monday? I said, oh, guess what I did over the weekend?
So he didn't even tell you?
He didn't tell me. He didn't video call me. He didn't do anything. No. I was like, what a waste of friendship.
Okay, let's...
Anywho, speaking about friendship...
I have apologized one time too many, but let's get into V's here right now. So it's about her.
Cool.
Not about me. Let's talk about collaboration and friendship. What is friendship to you? Because we see that over time, you stood up for your friends, mm-hmm. regardless of what the world thought about what you were doing, mm-hmm. or if they were going to cancel you, cancel culture.
Yeah.
You had the time to handle that. Yeah. And how did you handle it, first off? And what makes you stand for your friends, regardless of what anyone thinks?
There's actually one thing I'm really, really grateful for. I wasn't grateful for then, but I am now. It's the fact that I was myself. So coming out of the house, there was nothing to rehearse for or try and make it. I kept the same energy from when I entered the house to today. The way I am for my friends in the house, I'm still like that now. I think it's a bit different because we all have our different things to do, so I do like to give some distance. But my friends have a very, very special place in my heart. I take them very seriously.
Okay.
So I think I managed all of this by just being true to myself. At the end of the day, the world will adjust, and I feel like that's what's happening.
That's true.
Okay, so I do want to ask that, why did you move back to Nigeria to do music? Because I saw you had done a few features in the UK. You had done something with Afrobeat. Yeah.
Which we love, by the way.
We do love that one. So why did you decide, you know what, Nigeria is where I'm coming to, you know?
Weirdly enough, my mom asked me for my 21st birthday, what do you want to do for your birthday? And I was like, I want to go to Nigeria. So she paid for the ticket. I came when I was 21, and I just fell in love with Nigeria ever since.
Is it?
People look at me like, you're crazy. Why would you want to come to here?
And how's the malaria? Because I know you had like a bit of a back and forth malaria.
Me and malaria are best friends. You know, just one of the things that you just charge it to the game. But amongst all of the struggles that come with Nigeria, there's so much I've learned. I was very, very lazy when it came to my work, my mentality. And you learn how to have a hustler spirit here. There's so much things that you can take with you when you japa. Because, a lot of people's dream. But there are a lot of qualities in being a Nigerian that you can use for your good. And that's what I came here to learn.
Okay. Oh, that's sweet.
So collaborations in terms of music. I mean, you've done something with Laycon. You've also done something with Ladipo, who has a new EP out as well. What's what had you working with them?
With Young and Reckless, I told myself when I'm working on it, whatever feels good, I'm going to put on the project.
Mm-hmm. Right.
It just so happened that I worked on the song with Laycon first, and I worked on the song with Ladipo after. And then I asked my manager, Femi Soro, are these all the features? He was like, yeah, these are all the features. And we just let it be. We did what felt right. And those two, who would have known, two rappers with their names beginning with L.
Now it makes sense.
I wasn't even thinking of that. Very coincidental, but it just felt right. So we went with the flow.
All right, so we're talking to VI right now. And of course, she's got a new body of work out. You should take a listen. You would love it. I assure you about that. There's Show Me, there's Forbidding Fruit, which I'm curious about, but yeah. And of course, her fave, No Time.
Yeah. That's right. So do make sure that you have a listen. And whilst you do that, we will be back at 3 p.m. with the Spill Zone. We're talking about age and the pressures that come from it. So join in on the conversation on WhatsApp. You can give us a call in or hit us up on any of our social media platforms.
It's been great having you on the show today,
V.
And of course, we hope you come back to Abuja as often as possible.
Have you had Kilishi?
Yeah, I was going to ask that.
I've never had Kilishi before.
Femi, what's going on?
What's really the point?
What's going on?
I'm going to try.
You should try it.
You guys should give me a list of things.
Area one is the place. You should have Kilishi. You should have some Tuwo.
Yeah. Why not?
Maybe some Fura. That'd be good.
Fura will be good.
Okay, I'm going to make a list and get back to you guys.
Fantastic. We will make sure you do it.
Thank you.
Playing right now is Enter My Head, VI featuring Laycon.